everybody, and welcome back to The Wizard Sleeve. That's right, guys, I've been absent for a little while, about 2 weeks maybe, something like that. In truth, guys, I've got a bit of an apology, really. It's because, basically, work's been getting me down a little bit. Long story short, my boss is a cunt, and I hate her guts. Basically, I've just been really, really fucking miserable with life recently, and I've just not felt like making videos. I've not really felt like doing anything in the community, doing any hobby-related stuff. I've even found it a real, real struggle to push through with the creation of my Armies on Parade board, which is coming up in a couple of weeks' time. I've just not been feeling very good about myself recently. That being said, I've just been vegging on the couch and stuff and just, you know, wallowing in self-pity. Oh, woe is me. I've got a shit job. My boss fucking hates me. But anyway, guys, things have gotten a little bit better because the bitch is on holiday now. Way! So, 2 weeks of smooth sailing with no fucking nagging from that audible bitch. But anyway, what am I going to show you guys today? Well, it's a Wizard Sleeve episode, so I'm going to show you some stuff that's fantasy related. Now, you guys might remember from my other previous Wizard Sleeve videos, I'm doing a Kings of War Forces of Nature army. So I've got my Treelord Ancient as like my HQ. I've got like some beastmen and stuff like that to be counted as like fey creatures and count as like forest hunters or whatever it is. I thought to myself, do you know what would be really cool? Having some earth elementals. However, Mantic, I've just brought out some new earth elementals and they're okay. They're not bad. Did I say air or earth? Earth elementals, not air elementals, earth elementals. So Mantic's I've literally just come out with some new ones, and they look very, very nice, look really, really good, they look alright, I think. However, I've decided to make my own, because, I like making my own stuff. So what I have, guys, is these fellows right here. Now, hopefully, they're going to show up rather well on camera. If not, I do apologise. But these guys were made just using obsidian golems. These were three that I can't remember where I got these particular ones from. I think... Oh no! These ones were from, because I've got two lots, you see. These ones were from Chains, and I've got another three from a subscriber that sent them in because he wasn't using them. And I thank you both. They will make a lovely addition to my Forces of Nature army. So, as you can see, it's a pretty basic colour scheme, and I've gone along the lines of making it a little bit more technical on this. What I did, I basically sprayed them all a very light grey, and then after that light grey, I literally just went in with some washes. I went in with, you can't really see these, because the airbrush off spray, I went in with a brown wash, and then whilst that was still wet, I smashed it all over with this European dust wash from Vallejo, and that created the stony effect that I wanted. So we're gonna look at this middle one first. I'm just going to bring him a little bit closer. So that created kind of like the stony effect that I wanted initially. And then I kind of went over and kind of like dry brushed it with like another light grey just to pick out the highlights and stuff. I wanted this literally to be look like it was made entirely of stone. And that was pretty much the paint job on these. So there's that one. The inner cores that I made, I wanted this to be like kind of like nature magic. So wow, that is really bright. So what I did, I went in with a very, very bright white in there with my airbrush and just sprayed around the area. And then after that, I went in with the Old Faithful green fluorescent from Vallejo here. People have been asking me which ones these are, and so you got a chance now. So it's Fluo 70.737, so that is, or 210, whichever way you go by identifying your Vallejo stuff. But that kind of made this really, really bright kind of green inner core, which just looks great. It looks like they're like that is like power source or something. Now, another thing that I did, because I wanted them to look, rather than just being stone and a basic paint job, I actually went in with my basing substrate. If I show you on the, whatchamacallit here, on my Treelord Ancient, I kind of use a mixture of brown, just cheap brown acrylic paint, sand, grit and gravel. So I went in with that, and I just dumped it all over the top to look like, you know, they've emerged from the ground and taken loads of stuff with them. I then pre-painted some bits. I have some bits left over here from like dryads and various other little bits and bobs to look like they're all leafy and kind of like growing out of the ground. And then after that, I went in just with some static grass over the shoulders as well, just again to look like, you know, this is like turf and earth and grass that they've just like dredged up as they've emerged from the ground and things like that. And I've done it on like the backs of their arms as well. And It's out of focus. And I think this really is a really good effect. I really, really like these. And once I get six of them, they're going to be an absolute force to be reckoned with. But yeah, guys, I just really enjoyed making these. They were just a really simple, really easy build to do. And it was just nice to be able to do something and then jump back in, you know, with, you know, some more Warhammer stuff. There is some more stuff that's going to be coming soon. I'm going to be doing some more 40k stuff. I've kind of like run out of, I had run out of ideas, but I've got some more ideas now, and I've got the old cogs working, so we should be seeing that. And you guys will definitely see Armies on Parade coverage there as well. But anyway, guys, so thank you very much for watching. It's only been a short video, this one, and hopefully I'll see you guys in the next video. As always, guys, don't forget to like, favourite and subscribe. We've got a bunch of new subscribers recently, so to you guys, I say hello. And yeah, don't forget to give that like button an absolute pounding. Don't forget to leave a comment in the doobly-doo down below. And if you're new and your first time you're watching this, don't forget to subscribe it. And as always, guys, don't forget to share. Sharing is the best way that you can actually help support the channel, because it helps reach a much wider audience. But anyway, guys, that's enough of me rambling. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys again. See you now, and goodbye.